Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. Hope you're having a great day. Today we're going to take apart a Super Nintendo, so let's hop right in. Okay, so now before we go and take apart the Super Nintendo, there's some safety measures we should take. Anytime you're handling electronics, you always want to make sure that the power is discharged from it. A couple ways to do that would be to leave it unplugged for a couple days so that the capacitors inside have a chance to discharge any capacitance left in them. The capacitors can hold high amounts of voltage, and if you touch them or put anything metal on them, you know, it could cause spark or even shock yourself, which could, you know, cause serious harm or even death in some cases. Another way would be to, with the console unplugged, is just to power it on and off a few times to make sure that any charge left in the capacitors is discharged and making it safer to handle. You always want to play it safe when handling electronics, because doing the wrong thing or touching the wrong area could seriously harm you, if not kill you. Okay, so the tools we're going to need are going to be a 4.5 millimeter game bit screwdriver, a Phillips head screwdriver. This is a PH1. I believe PH2 will work as well. I believe the PH2 is probably a better fit, but this will work just fine. Some additional tools, but not necessary, would be maybe a set of tweezers to help you get, you know, some of the screws out, or just, you know, extra pair of hands when you can't reach certain areas. And a plastic spudger, just in case you need help prying things apart. It won't damage the plastic. Okay. With the console flipped over, you're just going to want to take the six screws out from underneath. There are three on each side. These are the game bit screws, so we're going to remove those. And then we're going to flip the console over and shake out the screws and just rinse and repeat until all the screws are out. With all the screws removed, now the top shell should just pop right off. With the top shell off, we now have access to the internals of the Super Nintendo. And the first thing we're going to want to take apart is this eject mechanism. We're going to want to be careful because there's a spring on this side that we need to make sure doesn't go flying, and make sure that when we put it back together, we put it back in a specific way. And I'll show you that way when we take this out. So the best way to take this out is just to kind of hold here and then lift this bar up, tilt it up a little bit, and then you should be able to slide the whole thing out. Should keep everything else in place, and then just take everything apart. You're going to want to take note of the spring. It has a short part towards the top and a longer part at the bottom. The longer part is what plugs into this bottom hole right here. And then the top short one hooks in right like that. So when you put it back together, you're going to want to make sure that the top's in there and the hole is in there, that the spring is lined up before you put the hole back through it. Now we're going to want to take apart the controller board, which just kind of lifts up, and then there's a ribbon cable right here that we want to make sure, just gently pry it out, because this ribbon cable is fragile. And, you know, if you repeatedly plug it in and take it out, it could cause the ends here to fray, and, well, then you need to find. Now it's time to get to the power button, and you'll see that the power button is right here, but there's wires connected to the board back here. So you're just going to want to gently lift that out, and then taking your Phillips screwdriver, remove the two screws holding in the power button. Now it's time to take the RF shielding off, and that's going to consist of six screws, two there, two there, and those two there. The silver screws are longer and they hold the cartridge slot in place, so just keep that in mind for when you're reassembling it. With those screws out, the RF shielding should pop right off, and so does the cartridge slot. Now, this is a great thing to do if, say, your games aren't playing and you know the games work in another system where you know the games are clean. You can always take it apart up to this point and then use like a toothbrush or something and some isopropyl alcohol to clean out this area, and the top. And, you know, lots of times that fixes most of your issues. So this is an older revision of the Super Nintendo, so it has the audio board. If you have a one-chip Super Nintendo, you won't have this, and you can just disregard this step. But if you do have this, there's just two screws, one there and one there, that need to come out, and then it lifts from the board. All right, with the audio interface removed, we now have three screws in the back, one, two, and three, holding the motherboard to the bottom of the shell. We'll just remove those. The screw over here, this one is another silver one, and it's longer than the other two. So again, just make note of that for when you're reassembling. Okay, so all the screws should be removed. We should be able to just now take the motherboard and lift it out. And then also the bottom RF shielding will be attached, and that'll just come right off. Place that right back in the bottom shelf. Okay, so now we have it fully disassembled. And there's one more thing we can take off if you need to access this part of the motherboard, which, you know, has the capacitors, which for maintenance purposes, it's always good to replace those. So if you needed to get access to that, first you need to take off the screw holding the voltage regulator to this shroud, which also acts as a heat sink. So we're just going to take the screw out. And this screw is a little different as well, so just make a note of that. Just pry it up a little bit so it's just off of there. Flip it over and then just remove the six screws, I believe. Yep. One, two, three, four, five, six. This one is silver, while the rest of them are, you know, goldish, bronzish color. This one's, so just make note so that this one goes back in its place. And with all those screws removed, the bottom shielding part just falls right out. And now you have access to all these capacitors, the voltage regulator, all things that, you know, could and should be replaced with a console of this age, just to, you know, give it more longevity and make it run better. So there you have it. We've taken apart the Super Nintendo. I'm not going to bore you with the reassembly of it because it's just the same steps in reverse. You just want to make sure that you keep the longer screws where they're supposed to go, and that spring in the proper position when you're putting the eject mechanism together. So there we have it. We've taken apart the Super Nintendo, and we can see it in all its nostalgia goodness, I guess, right? If you like this video, please give us a like. If you feel so inclined to subscribe, please do so. Very much appreciated. And also, in the comments below, please let me know what your favorite Super Nintendo video game was. One of my favorites has to be Final Fantasy III, or technically Final Fantasy VI. But very much enjoyed that game, have very good memories with it. And it might be time for a playthrough again. Well, anyway. Thanks for hanging out, and we'll catch you again.